So you're getting ready to start your SAS certification journey. I'm Mark Stevens from SAS Education, and I'm here to give you 4 tips to jumpstart your SAS certification exam preparation. So tip number 1 is to know what's on the SAS certification exam. So that is an easy place to find it. Some people, you need a fancy Google search or to go out and look on the dark web, but it's right here on certification portion of our SAS.com website. If you pop into our credentials, you can see all of them listed out here. I'm going to jump into our most popular credential, our base programming specialist, and we'll take a look at where all this information is set up. So each credentials page is identical to the next. It lacks creativity, but it makes things easier to find. Quick overview of the credential, followed by, in this case, because it's a performance-based exam, we're going to provide you a demonstration of what it's like to help you get comfortable with the environment. The specific details, how many questions you're going to see, how long you're going to have, how much it costs. And then finally, the exam content guide. And this is the critical document. This is important. This is what governs what's on every certification exam. Each exam will have one. When you get here, you can see that we break it down into the different sections of the exam and then followed by all of the exam objectives, right? So we've got everything under here. Everything with an orange bullet on it is an exam objective. And I guarantee that you will see at least one question on your exam tied to each one of those exam objectives. Now, also, you won't see any questions on the exam that don't tie back to those objectives. Still a little vague, right? Still a little high level, like access data. Like, what do we mean by access data? So we want you to be more comfortable with the content, so we provide this expanded version of the guide, right? So you can see here, if I can get the right window up, here we go. If I'm looking at access data, we can see that actually blows out to 3 sub-objectives, right? So we can see we're looking at just using a set statement or proc import if you're trying to read in a CSV file, or finally the SAS Access XLSX engine, and that's a mouthful to say to get in there. But you're not going to necessarily see questions on all 3 of those objectives, depending on the form of the exam that you see. It might be just on the proc import or another component, but you're definitely going to see questions on accessing data. So once you've reviewed the content, I'm going to move on to tip number 2. Tip number 2 is make sure that you review the training and exam preparation section that we have. Again, every credential is going to have this section, and it's going to list everything that we have available to you. So you can see we start out with the SAS training, and if all these are hyperlinked to other resources, so we can see here, right, what are the available formats for the Programming 1 class. We've got e-learning, live web, instructor, whichever mode fits your learning style. And you notice that this e-learning version is actually available free, so you can get started at low cost there. If self-paced learning is more your style, just going through and learning on your own, look to the books section. We have the Certification Prep Guides, a very popular book. We have them available for our 3 most common exams, right? The Base Programming Specialist, the Advanced Programming Professional, and the Statistical Business Analyst all now have a prep guide. And you can click in, see how do you buy it, see the cost. They're cheaper than they used to be. The prices come down, that's helpful. But you can get it PDF or you can get it as a book format, whichever you prefer. Moving on, we see sample questions. Every exam is going to have sample questions. Usually it's about 10. So they're not going to be fully comprehensive of all the objectives, but they are going to provide you a good example of what a question looks like, what it feels like, about the level of difficulty. Even for our performance-based exams, we provide you with some sample projects that you can work through using library data sets that are available in the SAS Help library. So we want you to, be as comfortable as possible. So that gives you a good feel for look and feel of the questions. And if you want the full exam experience, the most fidelity, look into our practice exams. So practice exams are available for a lot of our exams, maybe not all of them, but you can see we've got a long list of 13, 14 practice exams. Those are built to the same specifications that our live exams are built. So you're going to see about the same number of questions, same level of difficulty, same weighting across objectives, right? Same look and feel. It's going to look and feel exactly like what you will see on the exam because we build it with the same test driver. So the practice exams provide a really good match up to what the live exams are. Now, can I guarantee that if you pass the practice, you're going to pass the live exam? I can't go that far, but we definitely see some correlation. People who do well on the practice exam tend to do well on the live exam as well. Okay, so that's tip two. Be familiar with all of this training content. Tip number three is to practice. We expect that you have experience with the SAS software when you come into the exam. And what you want to do in the case of base programming, events programming, is you want to write a lot of code in different ways. So I've got some little examples of code here, kind of getting into what my friend Elizabeth taught me when I first started learning SAS myself. She referred to it as what-if programming, meaning write a program one way, and then just for the fun of it, write it a different way. So here we might try subsetting with a where statement, and we run that code. And then you get a chance to look at your output and look at your log and see how SAS behaved. And then you can change it. Instead of subsetting with a where statement, right, you can do it with an if statement and see if there's any differences or if it all runs the same. But that's part of the experience, is figuring out what's different, what's the same. Even make mistakes. Yeah, some of you have maybe jumped ahead and looked at the code below and seen that's not going to work. And you are correct, right? Because when we see the log, our contains operator works fine in the where section. But when we get down into the if statement, it doesn't work. So there's an opportunity to say, okay, now I need something, I need to learn something new and figure out how to do that same task with a different set of operators or functions. So write lots of code. That's tip number three. And really probably can't overemphasize how important it is to get lots of practice. And I want to make sure that you know that everyone has access to SAS software. If you don't have it already, you need to find SAS University Edition, which is free SAS software for everyone looking to learn SAS. And if you're looking more about one of our machine learning specialist credentials, check out SAS Via for Learners. Tip four, leverage SAS communities, right? The things that are available, right? You've got this YouTube channel right here. With lots of great content, short videos, longer videos, all trying to help you become a better SAS programmer or SAS administrator, depending on what you're working on. And of course, there's SAS communities, right? Our SAS communities website has a ton of different forums, all in different areas. So whether you're focusing your certification journey on administration or analytics, lots of different communities here, including, I should point out, be remiss if I forgot it, there is a forum just dedicated to SAS certification. So if you have questions, you can come here and ask the community. We keep an eye on it. I've got a lot of responses in there. You'll see my name all over it. And it's a great place to interact with SAS users and SAS employees. Finally, there's a bunch of resources available right at for free on the SAS training website within SAS.com. If I go here to offers and pop down to free training, great summary of the resources that we have, starting out with some e-learning topics, full SAS e-learning courses that are available to you for free, and then a huge library of videos. So we've got all divided up into different topics. So maybe you're looking at the machine learning credential, and that's based on SAS Via, so you pop in and see that we've got 147 videos. That machine learning credential really focuses on Model Studio especially. So we can pop into Model Studio and see there's 28 videos there, 5-10 minutes long, to help get you exposed to SAS Studio. So wrapping up, right, we've got four tips that I hope will help you with your SAS certification preparation. We're looking at know what's on the exam, leverage that exam content guide. Number two, training and preparation, right? We have a nice summary with all the training and preparation material that you need to be successful on the exam. Three is to practice. Get your hands on SAS certification software and write lots of code. And finally, don't forget to leverage all the different community resources, this YouTube channel, SAS Communities, our website, and all the free resources on SAS training as well. So hope you liked the video. Don't forget to subscribe up here. And if you have ideas for future content, feel free to offer some suggestions in the comments. Thanks. Bye.